this private school decided to show President Barack Obama as a munchie. Put up the graphic. Okay, let me give you some background to this. There's a wave of controversy now after students were given an assignment titled An Introduction to Primates. Okay, and former President Barack Obama's photo was prominently listed. So earlier this month, during a biology class lesson, an assignment was passed out to students instructing them to pick from the gallery of photos labeled apes, monkeys, and lemurs. And there in the second row is former President Barack Obama. Let's put up a picture of the school. Okay, the school is known as Roeper School. It is the oldest K through 12 school for gifted children in the United States of America. The Birmingham private school claims it prides itself on diversity and an alternative education that costs basically $30,000 a year. Let's put up the graphic again of the lesson that they received. That's what your $30,000 is getting you in the oldest gifted children program in the country. Okay, here's what the Roeper School said in a quote. We are aware the lesson taught and continue to review the incident. We are not providing additional information out of respect for the privacy of our community members. They're talking about white people. Okay. Right, white power structures need to be protected here. White people are involved. We need to protect white people. So that's their community. They're not concerned about the community of adversely impacted children. And by the way, black children are part of this program. Black parents are affiliated with this program. Black administrators are connected to this program. They're not concerned about them. They're concerned about protecting the status quo, the actual power structure of programs like this. All right. Fox 2 also obtained a letter that was sent to the parents. All right. So they did kind of address it. Here's what it said. The worksheet was taken from a highly regarded university. That's what they said. They're blaming it on a highly regarded university website and assigned in a high school biology class. The letter said in part, on behalf of Roeper School's leadership, I would like to acknowledge the disturbing racial offense contained in this worksheet and sincerely regret its use and the harm it caused. Can I remind everyone that this was an actual assignment that had to be downloaded by an administrator or educator, had to be looked at, reviewed, vetted, and then actually assigned to students. So you mean to tell me that your program of gifted children, that you do not have gifted administrators, that you do not have gifted teachers? As a matter of fact, your teachers are quite silly. Your teachers are ridiculous. Your teachers are adversarial to actual education. You have a deeper problem than just this one assignment. And in your own explanation, you throw a mystical, unknown, unnamed university under the bus. A highly regarded university did this to us. Highly regarded. As long as I say highly regarded, that means white. A white college that well respected did this. Now, damn it. We're not going to violate our community members by letting you know the truth. There's more. The school is offering counseling to students affected by the assignment. How big of them. And they'll continue training staff to educate on racial bias in the classroom. The letter also stated that the teacher has taken responsibility and admits to not properly vetting the resource. It did not state where exactly the assignment was obtained. Yes, it was obtained from a highly regarded university. Educator has taken full responsibility for this, and we are going to train them not to refer to black people as monkeys. All right, what else do you want? If you have to create a training program so that your teachers do not teach that black people are monkeys and apes, you're way past programming here. You're way past the spectrum of implicit bias or unconscious bias. This is absolutely hyper aggressive bias. Let's put up a picture of the head of school. There he is. David H. Feldmanis. He's the person in charge. He's the guy protecting everything. Now remember, conservatives want you to think that critical race theory is the worst thing in education in America when it's not even taught in K through 12 education. Here's the problem. It's not that critical race theory is not taught. It's the fact that it should be taught. And the reality is these educators who not only submitted this as an assignment, you see the culture of protection around this enterprise of neglect and racism. All right, really pisses me off. I'm a former educator in high school, and I don't understand how anyone would remain on staff, my dear brother, after doing something like this to kids. All right, what are your thoughts?
Well, you know, you pointed it out beautifully there. There's no way this was just one single individual failure there. You know, there's a chain, especially when you're talking about a very, you know, $30,000 a year private school. There is this chain of command. Typically, individual teachers aren't just coming up, you know, oh, let me get on this university website, download this, here's your assignment, especially not in a school that prestigious. So there's likely somebody that creates the curriculum for the grade. So there's one person, at least that we know of. Maybe it's a teacher, maybe not, but there's one person. Second, typically in instances like this, the teachers do not print out their own materials. The materials are printed out, you send them down to the, right, you know, whatever department in the school to do that. So at least two people at that point would have seen that this happened. There's likely another one to two people, depending again if they have an individual putting together the curriculum. So you're talking minimum of two, probably three to four who saw this, looked at it, understood what it said, and said, okay. Because let's also not forget, if this was an assignment, the teacher had also had a copy.
That's right.
So that they knew, you know, what the answers would be. Yeah. And that actually is the copy that I'm curious about.
Yeah, what's the answer key?
Exactly. What did they put? Because they had it on there. They had to have had the answer key ready to go for the homework that was going to come back the next day. What did that answer key say? And I'm sure we'll never know that. I'm sure it probably has disappeared by now. But this is very telling. It's telling on the school. It's telling on the administration. It's telling on everybody along that chain of command. And if this did in fact come from an actual college, as they claim, a highly regarded university, which university? Because we need to know that as well. That we need to find out who is also teaching this horrendous lesson. And parents, if you're sending your kids to the Roeper School, I think you ought to know your $30,000 is buying your students lessons that are copied and pasted off the internet.
Right. And listen, man, it's a damn lie. They didn't get this from some kind of highly regarded university. What highly regarded university would have that kind of simple ass ridiculous assignment on their website anyway? That the story is just convoluted and ridiculous.